Thanks, Anu, and thank you, Meta Health family, for giving me the invitation to speak today. Thank you, everybody, whoever is attending this, and thank you for taking time out to hear me. So this talk today is basically about my inspiration in life, along the journey of my life since I was a little girl of 13. That's been painting. To me, art as painting has always been a fascination. So when I was about 13 years of age, I used to visit a lot of exhibitions and shows with my parents, a lot of art shows. You know, I was in Delhi, and Delhi has a lot of art shows. My parents are very culturally oriented. So I would always visit shows with them. My cousins were artists, are still artists. And somewhere, probably they just picked up that I like to paint. And I don't know where I showed the inclination, probably I did. And they went and got me some canvas, and they got me some oil colors. And at that time, the tubes were very small and different. And Camel was the brand at that time. And they got me some turpentine oil and some brushes. And the shopkeeper gave us some vague idea of how you actually mix the things and how you use them. So I just picked up the brush and colors, and I started painting, having no idea what I'm painting. And probably I was painting abstracts. And then my first painting, I very clearly remember, because it was, very prominently displayed at my parents' house for many years, was a 2 feet by 3 feet canvas displaying a little ship that is going through a valley. And the colors were purple, blue, yellow, and green. And I think it stayed there for some 20 years or so. It was just stayed there. And after that, I just kept painting, and they kept getting me canvas and colors and encouraging me always to paint. So I probably learned from them that you've got to get what your child really wants to do and just pick on it and allow him to focus on what he wants to do and let him keep doing it always, because that's where he is going to be. That's where his heart is. And maybe I learned it from them, and I carried it out with my son, who's an actor today. My parents, in fact, made greeting cards out of the paintings that I made. I joined Lady Sri Ram College to do my graduation, but I wasn't interested in going to a regular college. And I said, no, this is not where I want to go. I want to pursue art in College of Arts. So although I missed a year, they didn't really, say very much. They tried their level best, and I got the next year into the College of Arts. So they always kept inspiring me, and I always kept moving more and more towards art and painting. Then I very soon, in fact, got married, and throughout my marriage bursts, and it's been like a spurt of inspiration that comes to me. So wherever we've got posted, I have picked up canvas and colors, and I've been painting. And my paintings always tell a story. I will show you some paintings towards the later half of the talk and tell you a bit about them. So wherever we got posted, I held shows and exhibitions, and by the divine grace, they did pretty well. After I paint every painting, I realize that there is a story, and the story just comes up into my head, and I would write it along with the painting. So whoever came to see the picture also got to read the story along with the painting. I was in Hyderabad about 10-12 years ago, and I came down with fever, and this fever persisted. It refused to go for months and months on end, and we showed various doctors, and they gave me all kinds of antibiotics, all kinds of tests were done. They couldn't understand what's wrong with me, because frankly, except for the fact that I was running temperature and I was feeling low, there was nothing detected at all. And in fact, I think about a year, 6 months to 8 months to a year, the temperature, I kept trying various antibiotics. But then I realized something just told me, hey, you got to go get your canvas and get your colors and start painting. And so therefore I went to the market, I picked up canvases, lots of them. I'm always like that. Whenever I go to an art shop, I like go crazy. And I pick up lots of colors and lots of canvases and all tools to paint. And no one can stop me from picking up various collectibles from the art shop. So then I picked up all these accessories from the painting shop and I came back home and I just started painting. And that's where I realized that I really love painting. And when I realized that I love painting, a part of me told me that I love myself too. The more I painted, the more I realized that I truly love myself. So therefore, I felt that this is my passion. And when I'm following my passion, when I'm following my heart, I'm beginning to love myself more and more. It's like I'm nurturing myself more and more when I'm following my heart. Of course, I'm taking care of everybody and everybody's taking care of me. But at the same time, I'm also doing something for myself, and that is painting. So I had a beautiful home in Hyderabad. I had a lovely lawn and a lovely veranda, because in places like Hyderabad and Chennai, where also I was, you have the luxury of these big homes, unlike Mumbai, you know. You have the luxury of being in these big homes. So I would sit down in my veranda. In spite of the heat, I would just put a table fan there and sit down in my veranda with lots of greens around me and my dog somewhere floating around. And I would pick up colors and brushes and just keep painting. And I really didn't know what's going to come out. I had nothing in my head, but all my feelings, all my love for art, for myself, would just pour out on canvas. As a result, I think one of the best paintings that came out was at the time when I was in Hyderabad. And you wouldn't believe it, no medicine could cure me, but me following my passion, falling in love with myself again, really helped me heal. And I was completely cured. After that 1 year, we came back to Mumbai and I was completely cured. There was nothing wrong with me at all. And I didn't need to even go back to a doctor because there was nothing to check. And I had a show of my paintings, which did really well. And I'm not a very modest person. I did paint well. I made some nice stories and my art sold very well. And that gave me even more validation of my own self that I am good. And I started loving myself more, and it gave me the opportunity to nurture myself more in the same field. That so happened that life in Mumbai was great. I mean, everything was really going well. Then about 5 years ago, again, I came down with severe vertigo. And I went to the doctor. Of course, he's a very wonderful doctor. He gave me medication, which is meant to be there. Vertigo is, for some people, it comes and goes. For me, it persisted for 5 months. And I couldn't, for the first 2-3 months, I couldn't look sideways, walk, looking up, down, or, even lying down straight. And it was very troublesome at that time for me. So I didn't know what to do. And something just sprang in my head. And I said, I don't care. I sent for a box of crayons. I sent for a box of sketch pens and some coloring pencils. And I sat down with paper and I just every evening would sit down and paint one painting a day and finish at night. And before I finished it, I wouldn't get up. So I would paint a mandala, or I'm fascinated by animals. So I would paint some abstract animals and they would just keep coming up and coming up. Every day something came up. And I utilize, for me, my vertigo was a brilliant phase. I don't take it as something which was like, oh God, why did it happen to me? It's like, it was a brilliant phase for me because I stopped working for those 5 months. I dedicated those 5 months completely to myself. I painted whatever I wanted to. And every time I made a painting, I would put it up on Facebook, just like I do even today. And I was truly appreciated for whatever I was doing. Of course, nobody knowing what was happening with me otherwise. And it just started healing me again. Somehow it's been such... So when you're following what you love, because somewhere within me, it's also one of my love. So when you're following what you love, you start healing. There's something within your space that just starts sorting out on its own. For some people, it's art, like painting. For some people, it's music. For others, it may be cooking or maybe simply walking or talking to somebody. So it just varies for everybody. And the more I would paint, the more I would fall in love with myself, the more I would realize that I need to nurture myself more. So I used to get my cook to make the best, healthiest cuisine for me, whatever I love to eat. I told him, Jao, go to the market, get me this sabzi. and just make this for me. And I would pamper myself. Those 5 months, I work as a holistic healer for 19 years. So for those 5 months, I didn't work at all. I was just visible on Facebook with my sketches and my colors and my drawings. And the last 2 months that I did this, after that, I was just sorted. The vertigo just vanished. I mean, I couldn't even remember that I had this sort of a feeling for 5 months. This persisted excessively for 3 months. It just vanished. It magically vanished. So for me, painting has been like therapy as well, because it's been my love. So whenever we follow ourselves, we are loving ourselves more and more. We are nurturing ourselves more and more. So just do it for yourself. Love yourself completely. Loving ourselves means nurturing ourselves, following our heart, doing what gives us our inner sense of joy. And that's what I've been doing all along with art. So now again that I am in Mumbai, I was away for 2 years, and I'm back in Mumbai, painter again called out and said, hey, you got to go to the shop, pick up your canvas again, pick up some paints and start doing it again. So again, I've gone and bought some canvases, and I've been painting since end of last year, not too long. And I came back mid last year, and I've been painting since end of last year. And it's just been a continuous process. And for me, it's not like, you know, I paint for a few days and then I say, okay, I'm done. It's not like that. It has to just go on. It's like if a journey begins, it has to go on. So I'm going to now show you a couple of my miniature paintings where I've just started with something very new end of last year, which is called knife art. And since I said each of my paintings tells a story, so therefore here is one painting. These are the miniature ones. This is done as knife art, and this is a ballerina. So it's a ballerina, and she is unfurling herself and she is dancing. And notice the colors of the painting, because I love vibrancy, I love colors. So all my paintings will be like that. So in her dance also, she's gradually unfurling herself. So that probably somewhere is, every artist has a part of him that describes him, the way he feels. And I must be feeling this way that day. So therefore, this is what I painted. Then I'll show you another one, which is a Sufi saint. This is inspired by Rumi. And this is, again, a miniature, all done with knife. A knife means it's another tool, like we have brushes. We also have palette knives. So instead of using brush on canvas, you're using palette knives to sketch out these colors. So all this and the effects are done with palette knives. But this is somewhere probably the side of me which is always looking up and always looking up, because I know His grace is there. This is another miniature done with knife. It's a monk at the peak, and he's looking further and further because he knows that there is only light. And he's marvelously looking at the light, inspired by the light. This is again a knife art. This is Bruce Springsteen. I loved him. I really loved him. I went to see his concert when I was a teenager. I think I was 13 or 14. He came to Delhi to perform. And I went with my dad, and he very lovingly, escorted me there. And he actually stood there all throughout the concert like an escort, only protecting me as he was always. And I love this guy. I still love him. I believe he sang Born in the USA, and I believe there's something called Closed in the USA or Barred in the USA or something, which has come down now in the lockdown, which is really sad, but I love his songs. I can't show you most of my paintings because they are rather large, but this is another one. Now this is called the finale. So this is actually showing the start of a performance till the end of a performance. So it starts from here, and the finale is at this point. So we go on performing in our life across the journey and the various situations of our life till the life comes to an end. You could even interpret it as the performance of music. Actually, when I made it, to me, it was music. So it is the performance of a concert, and at the peak, it's at the peak here, till it again comes down. So this is the finale. To me, it's a concert. I also have been trying out something new called acrylic art, or the art pour. Now, this started somewhere in 1930s by an artist called David. He was a Mexican artist, where you just allow the colors to pour on your canvas. So you just pick up the colors of the acrylic and pour it on your canvas. And here, to me, this painting reflects a lot of me. It's me in bits and portions. It's actually all my journey till where I am today, starting from here till here. So it's very narrative, but obviously we can't talk about it in detail here, but it's extremely narrative to me. The journey beginning from here till here, where I see myself. I love the color blue. So a lot of my paintings, though they are huge right now, I can't show them, but a lot of them have the use of blue, cobalt blue. And there's a rather bigger canvas here. And that's an abstract. So these are the various phases of life that a person goes through. And it is done with various textural methods. So on the one hand, I have oil paints here, which are showing you various textures. Here I have used other textures of fluid art. And here I have used knife for my palette. So this is various textures showing us various phases of life, but life is always opening up to light. Every phase after every phase is light. At the beginning of every phase is light. So there is hope always. I could call this painting Hope, actually. I haven't yet titled my paintings. I wanted to have a show, but let's see if it works online now. I'm not sure how it works. So I know that's a quick go on what I've been doing with art and painting.
Well, she's my guru, actually. So happy Guru Purnima to you.
Thank you.
And she's been fantastic as a guru for all of us. I mean, I think a lot of people, I don't know why they're not showing their faces. Most of them here are students of Purnima, and whatever she says, there's a lot that we learn from her. So right now, when she's talking about her paintings and the stories that she has behind them, there's something to learn for us from that.
Anji?
That when you express yourself and give into what you really love, you heal. You see, because she is all about healing. Now there's a, I think I was one of her, maybe the first 50 students of hers, you know, the first lot. And there's every time we would go to her a little hideaway, or not that little office of hers, which was just had this fantastic vibration and this fantastic vibe about it. Every time she had these meetings, there was always a lot of abundance of happiness, abundance in the whole group. There was some kind of a light always, and abundance of food, because we always used to, I don't know, everyone used to get food and used to eat and jolly, make jolly and everything. And it's something that we're really, really missing, because what she says when she says that I went into something I love, and that healed her, healed everything. So, that was something that she did. She was giving healing over there to everybody, and that was all with a lot of love, and everyone reciprocated the love. I mean, a lot of people here are her students.
Hi, Purnima. Hi, Anno. I love the monk standing on the peak. That was such a beautiful painting, and it actually expressed connectedness to me. And interestingly, when you said blue color seems calmness to you, it actually felt expansion to me. So I don't know what exactly the color means or what exactly the color interpretation is all about. But while you were showing your paintings, I actually felt expansion.
Wow.
Beautiful work, Purnima.
Wow.
Thank you. Thanks, Anu. Appreciate you.
Yeah. शायद किसी को आपके साथ हाथ पकड़ के चलना आ जाए. जब आप चलोगे तो शायद आपका हाथ पकड़ के कोई आगे निकल जाए.
Thank you.
Sarita, would you like to share how you felt?
Hi, thank you, ma'am. So thank you, Purnima.
Congratulations.
Thank you so much. Thank you so much, ma'am.
हाँ बिल्कुल कहना बिल्कुल
अभी बाय होगी जब बुला लूंगी आपको ठीक है So, beautiful paintings, Purnima ma'am. And what I really connected to is that I also love doing paintings. And what I have learned from doing paintings is that they are full of life. And that is what I connected with in your paintings. You said that all your paintings were full of life and full of hope. One thing that I have learned from my paintings is that you can always repaint your canvas. Absolutely. So that is what I have learned, that things can never go wrong. You can just add, delete, do whatever you want to your canvas. So that is what I loved in your talk also. So thank you so much, ma'am.
I have done it to so many of my paintings. You can't.
Yeah. So thank you for such an inspirational talk, ma'am. Thank you.
Purnima, love to you. Yeah. And I remember the first time I met Purnima, I sat over there and I was staring at two paintings which were there in the office. And I was staring at it because it was so beautiful. So when she told me that she is the one who had painted, I could imagine that it's so beautiful. I thought, you know, it must be costing a bomb or something. It was so beautiful. And these paintings, the colors, every painting made me feel, you know, I was like in one with the colors. And when she said blue, I totally aligned with that, because even my favorite color is blue. Let's see, I'm wearing blue and white. So every painting I felt wow, you know. So the ballerina was so beautiful, even the monk and the music concert one. I loved it. I loved all of them. I can understand why you're saying that, because I have noticed in my life also, when I do something which I like, I think that day I'm the happiest, when I'm doing something that I like. And when I'm forced to do something, then there is a problem. If I have to do something for the sake of doing, then it's a problem. But whenever I do something which I love, that day goes so beautiful. And it is really, really healing. I know, I totally understand you. So,
yeah. Hi, Anu.
Yes, hi.
On my video. I had to change my position a couple of times so that I could switch on my video.
Wonderful.
To be on your show and to hear Purnima, who is my dear sister.
Oh, nice.
Yeah, so Purnima, nice. It was beautiful. It was fascinating to hear you. And of course, she's always done very vibrant paintings, and she's got this vibrant personality also. No doubt about that. So Purnima, keep up the good work. Follow your passion.
Thank you.
And yeah, it was lovely to see those new paintings that you've been working on.
Thank you, everybody. Thank you.
Thank you, Anu. Thanks.
Thank you, everybody. Yeah, thank God for every moment of my life. And thank you for inviting me today. It's Guru Purnima. So it's God's gift to me. Thank you, Anu, for this gift. Thank you, Meta Health family. Thank you all. Love you. Thank you.
Thank you.